Hi everybody and welcome to another tutorial by KS Solutions. In this video we will consider the geometry of a woven fabric in plain yarn arrangement and how we can create an equivalent model in LS prepost that retains the geometry with yarn interactions, which is an assembly of fibers, while decreasing the numerical complexity. So I have extracted my representative volume element or RVE of a plain woven fiber glass I work with in the lab. You can see it in this picture here. I used the freeware software to create a geometry called textile. Then we can see that the resulting topology is not great and we will most likely have element quality issues when meshing this. Also, if we want to use a larger geometry in the scale of centimeters, creating a short mesh will result in very heavy models. So another approach is to represent these yarns by beam elements, and this is what we will be doing here. So stay tuned and let's see how this is done in LS DYNA. So in order to do that, we go to the geometry and we use the composite curve tool and we go to the edges and extract these edges as paths. We will be using these as paths for the beams. We do that for all four yarns. Next, we need to align these wires in the middle, the fibers. So we need to calculate the dimensions of the solid fibers. And we use the ID measure for that. So now we know the dimension of the wire, transform these wires in this direction by half this magnitude. And as we see now, they are in the middle of the solid domains. And we do the same thing for the wave fibers as well. We delete the unnecessary wires. We don't need this anymore. Now that we have our wires in place, we are ready to create our beam elements. In order to do so, we are going to use the element generation tab. And go to the beam section. We are going to select curve. And we are going to select each curve separately. and assign the number of elements for its section. You can select the number of elements in this tab. Here we will select 0.1 millimeters, but you can increase this number depending on the flexibility you like and the accuracy of how the fibers you would like to move. Of course, higher number will be more computationally expensive, but it will provide more realistic movement. Now that we have the beam elements in place, we will create a pattern in both X and Y direction, the warp and weft and directions. So we'll create a macroscopic geometry that we can then use for different applications. So now we are calculating the dimensions of the representative volume element in order to multiply it in the X and Y directions. We'll first go ahead and apply transformation. And transpose in the y direction, we will copy this representative volume element a total of 9 times. Here we go, we now have our geometry. And last point, now we have to clear our model from the duplicate nodes. In order to do that, we'll go to the element tools and duplicate nodes option, and we'll choose our model. We'll go show duplicate nodes. We need to be careful with the tolerance, not to include neighboring nodes. So choose appropriate dimension, and we press merge. So we merge the duplicate nodes, and now we are ready for our next step.